The purpose of this video is to determine the angle of rotation when we draw and draw an image on our screen. The goal is to draw an image on the screen and angle it in such a way that it points at the mouse. So I need to know, what is this angle of rotation? So I do know the location of the center and of the mouse. So I can calculate delta x, which is the difference in x values, and delta y, which is the difference in y values. So how can we use trig functions to help us determine the angle? Well, trig functions use a right triangle and a given angle, here theta. So the right triangle has legs that are named. So the side opposite of theta is called opposite, and the leg adjacent is called adjacent, and then we have the hypotenuse. So you can just abbreviate those as O, A, and H. So we have an easy mnemonic, SOHCAHTOA, that reminds us of the ratios that are used for the trig functions. So the sine of theta is equal to the opposite divided by the hypotenuse, and this is true for any given angle, regardless of the size of the triangle. The cosine of theta is equal to the adjacent leg divided by the hypotenuse, and the tangent of theta is equal to the opposite leg divided by the adjacent leg. For our problem, we know the two legs of the triangle, the adjacent leg and the opposite leg. So of these three trig functions, the one that we need to use is the tangent. So back to our triangle with the center of rotation and the mouse. So we've determined the adjacent leg distance and the opposite leg distance. So how can we determine the angle? Well, we said we would use the tangent of theta. Tangent of theta is the opposite divided by hypotenuse, or I rewrote this as delta x divided by delta y. We already know this number. What we need to do is reverse engineer tangent to determine this angle. And we actually can't use tangent for that. We need to use its opposite, called arctangent. So if we use the function arctangent and pass in delta x divided by delta y, it'll return to us the angle. So in our program, we would calculate it this way. Rotation, which for me is the angle of my rotation, equals math.a arctangent, and we're going to pass in delta x divided by delta y. And that'll return to us this angle for rotation. But we have one problem we need to fix. If this is the center of our rotation, it's possible for the mouse to be in this quadrant, or this quadrant, or this quadrant, or this quadrant. And I've written delta x, delta y values here, here, and here. And let's take a look at their signs. Here, they're both positive, but here, they're both negative. Here, one's positive, one's negative, and here, it's the opposite. So the problem comes in here. When we divide delta x by delta y, the negative signs cancel out. So this quadrant looks like this quadrant, and this quadrant looks like this quadrant. So the function arctangent is only going to give us a value in the range of 180 degrees. That's not really what we want. We want the full 360. So what is the fix for that? The fix for that is using a different function called atan2 or arctangent2. Instead of calculating the quotient before we pass in the value, we just pass in delta x and delta y as separate arguments. That allows arctangent 2 to determine which of the four quadrants we're in, and it gives an angle that's in the full 360 degrees. Technically, arctangent and arctangent 2 return the angle in a measure of radians. So now that you know how to use trig functions to determine your rotation, you should be able to draw your image rotated perfectly. Good luck.